Week six. So today we have our week six online course of e-learning. In this section, we will finish HSK2 vocabulary. And altogether, we will learn 300, maybe there's three more, I can't remember. 300 words together we reviewed and we expanded a lot of them. I hope you guys made a very solid foundation on your HSK2 vocabulary. So after today, then we'll focus on HSK3. All right, so let's get started. We have 70 words today. So 231, that is a sport, which is 跑步. Oops. 跑步. This is a verb which literally means to run or to jog. For example, you can say 今天天气不错. Or 爸爸去哪儿了? The answer can be 他去跑步了. You also can separate the 跑 and the 步 by saying 早上去外面, go outside. 跑跑步, 跳跳舞. So dance a little bit, run or jogging a little while. Okay, you also can say 跑一会儿步, run or jogging for a while. Okay, so this is 231, 跑步, 跑步. And do you notice the first character, 跑? And if you pay attention, you might see this radical here. This one, the left part. All right. You will see this this literally from the character 足. So this is the foot. Foot. No food. Foot radical. Okay, which literally means foot. So if you say this one, and it has something to do with your feet, either it's a verb or something else, but it won't write like the foot this way. The last stroke will be go up, like a T radical, T stroke. 好, 232. And this one. 便宜. Literally adjective. Which means cheap. Okay. You can say the sentence in the lesson, which is 这件衣服真便宜. Or if we use the sentences we learned in HSK lesson 1, not at all, the structure, remember? Not at all sentence. So this let's make a sentence. This cup is not expensive at all. So we're going to say subject 这个杯子. Not even a little bit expensive, right? 一点儿. Yeah, or you can use 都, both okay, yeah or 都. 不, or 没, but because 没 is normally used to describe the verbs instead of adjective, sorry, instead of adjectives, so we cannot use 没 here. We can only use 这个杯子一点都不便宜, which means this cup is not cheap at all. This is 便宜. And the opposite meaning, which is 贵, 贵. This is expensive. 便宜, expensive, 贵. Normally we complain 太贵了, or 有点贵. Or this one compared to the other one, 贵一些, 贵, expensive a little bit. Okay, this is 233. 233. A noun. 票. Ticket. Absolutely a noun. Ticket. It normally can combine, if it's a noun, if you want to be specific, it normally combines whatever nouns in front of it to describe it. For example, train ticket will be 火车票, movie ticket 电影票. Okay? Or if you go to a theme park and you need to purchase the ticket at the gate, well, you say 门票. If you want to buy a ticket, which is 买一张, pay attention to the measure word here, 张票, because 张 is used to describe something is flat, and 票 is flat. So 买一张票. It's not much to talk about that. And 234. 妻子. So this one, noun obviously, which means wife. Okay, you can say 我的妻子, or 我妻子. Well, this should go neutral, because if you say 妻子, which means wife and son and kids, so it's supposed to go neutral. 妻子. 妻子, 我的妻子, 我妻子. There's multiple ways to address your wife, and it can also be, if in a very formal occasion, you can say 太太. Alright, and for husband, we'll say 先生. 太太, 先生. 张太太, 张先生. There are a couple. A more common way, which we say 老婆, 老婆. This is a very, you can use this to introduce your wife to your friend. This is my, 这是我老婆, but this is a very informal, very casual way. And you can also call each other this name. And at home, you can call your wife, 老婆, 老婆, can you help me get something? 老婆, can you bring me something that I need? 老婆, can you drive the car to school? Okay, so you can use this as a nickname. And the opposite, which is 老公, 老公, also a address, And then if you have a Chinese girlfriend or wife in the future, and she may call you 老公, if I have a husband in China, and he will call you 老婆,老公,老婆. And there's another way, one way to say this, 爱人. So 爱人 also means partner, the people you loved, 爱人, but it refers to husband. All right, you can introduce your significant others, significant other to your friends by saying 这是我爱人, which means you're already married. All right, 这是我爱人,爱人. So it doesn't matter which it's a male or a female, and you can use 爱人 to introduce your partner. For opposite meaning of 妻子, which is 丈夫。好了，235。One of the hardest thing in the morning, which is 起床。起床. This is a verb. For example, 今天我们要去公园. We're going to the park today. 今天我们要去公园。快点儿, hurry up. 快点儿起床. Okay.And then also mom will ask you, 起来了没有? Did you get up yet? 起来了没有? So here we don't use 床 again. So when we say 起来了, we're talking about getting up from your bed. 起来了没有? Okay, 起床,快,起床. Normally it's rushing you get up quickly. So 快起床,快起床. Okay.Oh, I'm too tired. 我不想起床。我不想起床。Okay, so that's 起床。236, which is 千。千。This one literally means thousand. Thousand.So, but if you want to say 1,000, you can't say this. Thousand. This is a number. You can say 1,000, 1,000.Alright, then 2,000 只狗, 2,000 dogs. This is 2,000 dogs. Okay, and not much to talk about this. 2,000, 3,000, remember the others. And we learned by 100. 100, actually. You cannot just say it's 100, it's 100. And then 1, which is...Literally means 10,000. 10,000. 1. Okay. 好了，237. When you do the test, you're going to use the... Is the font too small? I think I'm going to make it bigger.It's better? Better for your eyes. 好了, this is 铅, then 笔, 铅笔. 铅 literally means lead, and 笔 means is the general name for pen, so lead pen, which is pencil. Or you can use 钢笔, are. The gumby is a pen, which is you dip it into the ink, or you call it ink pen. Ink pen. So the one we're using today, it's kind of like a round ball on top of it. We call it a yobi, which means the round ball pen or ball pen. Gumby, yobi, ball pen. And there's a special one in China, which we call the Maobi. That's the brush for calligraphy. Maobi. Maobi. So, qianbi, gumbi, yobi, maobi. Alright, all kinds of bi. Or if you want to say paint, paintbrush, 画笔, 画笔. Okay. All right, this one, 请. Which is adjective, but you barely use this adjective by itself, solely. And you normally will make a word. For example, if you want to say sunny, it should be 晴天. Or the example can be 今天是晴天. Or you can ask, is the sun clear? Is the sky clear? You can ask 天, especially after a rain, or after a rainy day or a cloudy day. You can ask people 天晴了吗? 天晴了吗? Which means, is the day getting sunnier? The day getting sunnier. 天晴了吗? If you have to use, say, today is very sunny, right? And you can only say 天气很晴朗.晴, which means sunny. 朗 means clear. So you have to combine these two to use them together. If you just say 天气很晴, which is not right. Which is not right, okay? So this word barely used by itself solely. It has to combine with something else. Word used in this kind of structure. 天晴了吗? And the other situation might be wrong examples. So this is definitely correct answers. 好, 239. This is easy. 去年. 去年. So it's supposed to be 于, supposed to be this 于, but when it has 及其西 in front of it, there's no two dots. 好吗? 去年. Last year. And you can say, last year I was 19 years old. 去年我19岁. Our family, we go to China last year. 我们去年去了中国. Last year we went to China. 我们去了中国. And based on this, we can expand it to more years. If it's this year, we're gonna say 今年. Remember, we learned 今年我十六岁。Okay, this year, how old am I? The year before it will be 去年。And the year after it will be 明年。And then after it will be 后年。And the year before last year will be called 前年。Alright, so 前年、去年、今年、明年、后年。In time phrase, it will be, for example, 今年 which is 2016年，去年 will be 2015，then 前年 will be 2014，明年 will be 2017，and 后年 will be 2018。Okay, this is the based on the timeline. 前后 refer to locations in front or in the back. Also refers to before or after in time logic. 好了，二百四十。让。让, ooh, where is the pinyin? Okay, wait. How? So, 让 means, this is a verb, which means to let or to allow. Okay, to let or to allow. And we can have two examples. Let me think about it and then tell you. Okay, this is what we learned in lesson 8, HSK 2. Right? So, 让我想一想。让我想一想再告诉你。再告诉你。Let me think about it and then tell you. 让我想一想再告诉你。If you say, let me say this.让我看看，让我看看这本书。Let me see this book. 让我看看这本书。Alright, or, 张老师 asked me to call you. And you can say, 张老师 asked me, let me, 让我 call you, 给你 do what? 打电话。张老师让我给你打电话。张老师让我给你打电话。So, 让 is a very formal, it's a verb very useful. Like, normally somebody else asks you to do something, they will say, they 让 you do something. 让。好。241。日日我 It refers to multiple meanings. And the first meaning here in HSK2, which means day or date. Okay? For example, today, 今天是2016年。十月 October 十月十七日 Okay, today is 十月十七日 Or you can change that to 号 Both correct 好 And also the literal meaning the reason why 日 have the meaning of day is because it literally means sun So you can say, for the meaning of date, you can also say 今日 which equals today, which is 今天日 Alright, 好 another meaning which is the same 日 but it means sun, we barely use it unless we use it for days and the night. Okay, we can say 日日夜夜. Okay, 日日夜夜, days and nights. You work on the same project. 他日日夜夜写作业. He write his homework days and nights. 日日夜夜. Some doesn't normally don't use it by itself. Or you can make a word which is 日子, 日子, which means days. So 日子 passed by, day after day. All right. So never use, barely use it by itself. 242. This is an activity you guys are doing now. All right. 上班 上班 this means to work, and 班 literally means when shift. So you go shifts, you know, you run shifts, which means you go to work. And you say 上班, you in the morning you can tell your mom that you're leaving. You can say 我上班去了, or 我去上班了. I go to work. And or you can separate it, say 上了, I worked 一天, put a time in there, 班, okay? 上了一天班, I'm tired, 我很累. If on Friday I can say, hey, why you cannot answer my questions? Then you can answer 上了一天班, 我很累. I just, after finish the whole day's work, I'm just so tired, 上班. And the opposite meaning of this, leaving the work, will be 下班, 下班. Get off work. It doesn't mean quit the work, okay? 下班 means you're going home. Go home from work. It doesn't mean quit the work. 好, 243, 身体, 身体. Shenti is body, the alive body. Okay, so if you're dead or you refer to a dead person's body, it's a different word. So 身体, and this one is obviously a noun, which means body. And you can ask by other people, how is your body? How is your body's health? 你身体怎么样? How are you? Huh? Which means how are you? How is your body? How are you? But especially when you know this person in an unhealthy condition. For example, you know this person was thick, and you will ask him, checking on him or her, say, how are you? How's your health? 你身体怎么样? Or older people, like parents. This is a very polite way to ask a parent, or you can change 你 to 您. 您身体怎么样? It's a very good greeting to other people because you care about their health. 身体. Okay, 身体. 好了, 244. 生病. That's what I did last week. 生病. it's disappearing. This is the first tone. 生病. And you can say, 小狗不吃饭. Or we change it to lesson one. 小狗一点饭都不吃。不吃。 他生病了。So how come you didn't come to school? 你怎么没来学校? You can answer 我生病了。OK, 生病了。好, and 245。生日。 Same 生 as this one. 生 literally means birth. Okay, so we're giving birth. And 日 is the same with this. So I'm going to copy the pinyin. 生日. So, very simple. 生日. Today is my birthday. My mom, his birthday, 他的生日, 是, blah blah, plus day, 我好. And if you wish somebody happy birthday, you will say birthday happy. 生日快乐, 生日快乐, happy birthday. 生日快乐 Where you say 祝你 Wish you 生日快乐 Wish you happy birthday. And if you need to write a card for some people, and you can just use this one. 好, 246 时间, time. Let me put the pinging on there first. Time. 我很忙. I'm very busy. This is a noun. I'm very busy. I don't have time. 我没有时间，我很忙. Okay, 我在上班，我没有时间，我在上班，时间. There's another one we learned, which is 时候. Remember, it's the same one. This, but with the 后, 时候. 你什么时候？ 回家 你什么时候回家? So normally I can't say this is 100% correct, but you can use 时间 for period of time. And 时候 is asking about time point. 时候, 你什么时候回家? I want exact time. 你有时间吗? Do you have time? Do you have a period of time? Maybe 三分钟, maybe 3 minutes. 五分钟, 5 minutes. 时间, 时间, okay? And you can say 时间很多, 时间很多. Okay, I have a lot of time. 时间很多. 247 事情 This is a noun. 事情 is It has multiple meanings. It can mean a thing, can mean stuff, also can mean affair. But this affair doesn't refer to affair beyond a marriage. It's not the same 事情。今天我没有时间出去玩。Today I don't have time to hang out. Because 我有很多事情要做。To do, going to do. I have a lot of things going to do. Or, 我要做很多事情。I need to.I need to do a lot of work. I need to do a lot of work. 好 then 248. Shou biao, anything to do with hand. Oh, I need to remind you guys one radical when you're writing characters.And you know this character, right? For example, 打电话, right? This character, the left one, 打电话. This is coming from this character, 手, 手. So if you say this radical, it has something to do with your hand. It's a hand activity. And there's another one. It's a little bit different. You see the curve, right?You see the curve. This is the animal radical. You saw this one? Normally, it will have something to do with animals. Okay, so this one is dog. When you're writing characters, make sure this is straight, and this is curve, and that one, and this part, don't go beyond the curve line. Okay, but this one, go beyond the curve line because it's coming from the hand character. 好. So this is...手表 and which means watch. I forgot pinyin. Shou biao, watch. Shou biao. And for the measure word for shou biao will be yi kuai. It always go with the ritual final tone. So you can, based on yourself, okay? If you like pronounce the ritual flex tone, do it. Don't hesitate and do it. If you just hate the pronunciation, you just don't like to pronounce it, and without it will be fine as well.But if you're going to Beijing, prefer you will, I guarantee you will hear a lot of sound. 好了，一块手表。Even the Apple Watch, you need to use a quart as a measure word. 一块苹果手表，苹果手表 ，Apple Watch 手表。And for the bigger one, we don't call them 表. If it's not on the, if it's 表 is very small. If it's a bigger one, and we will call it 钟. Yes, it is the same 钟 with minute, but it literally means bell. So 钟 refers to a bigger watch.Well, you can't call it a watch any longer, but it refers to bigger ones, not which you can wear on your arm. 钟 and 表, they can separate. If you're going to fix your watch, and you will always say 钟 and 表 together. 好，二百四十九。 手机. Let's copy this. 机 literally means machine. So we're gonna make more words out of 机 later. So this is a 手机, a noun, which means a cell phone. Ooh, what's this? So this one means cell phone. Cell phone. And for any other words related with the show, and you can also say 手套, which means gloves. 手套, 手表, 手机. I think that's pretty much it. And there are other things which is very less frequent word, so not bothering for now. For 机, then you can say the airplane, which is the flying machine, 飞机. So this is means plane, 飞机. And that's it. All right, 250. 250. In China, if you call somebody 250, it basically means this a stupid person. So that's a cursing word. Also, a number two, you can call another people, you're so two. 你真二, which means you're, you know, not intelligent, you're stupid. 250. So let's say this one. 说话, talk. This is the meaning of 说. 说 means speak. 话 literally means language. 说话, to verb. To talk. To say something. If you say somebody, 说话 is a VO structure word. 话 is already a noun. So if you want to say she said something, you will say 她说, then whatever the context is. 她说什么什么什么什么. Okay? Now if teacher tell you stop talking, and 老师 will say 别说话, don't talk, 别说话, don't talk, don't start a conversation, don't set yourself in the conversation, 别说话. 我和妈妈每天, every day, 都在 Skype上, Skype上, 在 location, right? Skype is you know, it's not real, but not real location, but you know what we're talking about. 都在Skype上说一会儿, talk a while. 说一会儿话. 我和妈妈每天都在Skype上说一会儿话. 251. Disappearing again. I don't know why. 不知道为什么. So, this one to me means to send something or to deliver something. For example, 他送我. He sent me flowers. 他送我花. 他送我礼物，我送他 same 他巧克力 chocolate， 哦、oh, how sweet， 他送我礼物 she gave me a gift， she sent me a gift， I sent her chocolate， 他送我礼物，我送他巧克力。 It also means to deliver， 你呢 if you go to China you will do a lot of this。淘宝This is gonna be a useful website. You can get everything you want on Taobao. From products to services, everything, anything you need on Taobao, you can find the relative service. This is a surviving skill in China. 好 so you're gonna use Taobao, then you buy something, you bought something on Taobao, this website.And it will 送到我家 delivered to your house 送到我的办公室 delivered to my working office 送到我的办公室 Okay, this is 送 to send and also means to deliver 好252虽然 Let's do it in a phrase, in a structure. 虽然 blah blah blah, 但是什么什么什么 okay? Which means although or though. although, let's put a pinyin under it. 虽 when you I together and the tones always marked on the last one. 虽然但是So, after 虽然 you will give the first condition, and after but you will give your final conclusion. Okay. For example, although he's very handsome, but I don't like him. 虽然 it's not relevant though. 虽然他很帅 very handsome.Okay, or you can say 她很漂亮但是 but you know, the meaning will be completely turned 但是我不喜欢她但是我不喜欢她 Okay, so this is 虽然但是虽然今天天气很好 where we use it 今天是晴天 so what are you supposed to do during on a sunny day you normally go outside right and you can say 但是 but I don't want to go outside 我不想去外面 or 外边 虽然 although it's Sunday but I still don't want to goOkay, 虽然 blah blah, 虽然 A, then but B, 虽然 Okay, I still send him a gift, although it's not his or her birthday, 好吗? Let's try to make this. 我还是 you don't use 虽然 now, but you will use it later.我还是送他一个手表。Let's do this. 虽然今天不是他的生日。Even though it's not his birthday today, I still send her a watch. 我还是送他一个手表。虽然今天不是他的生日。Alright, so this is the meaning of 虽然。Which one are we? 250. 二, so let's do 253. 所以, still let's do this in a frame to remember this frame. You can abbreviate the frame later when you get used to it, but if not, wait, what am I doing? If not, you'll stick with these sentences because this is 100% guaranteed correct, okay? B-E-C-A-U-S-E, because, so, give the result, 好吗? Alright, let's do this. Because something, so I will do something, or therefore I will do something. Okay? 因为, same example as this one. Let's change it. Because it's his birthday, so I will give him a watch. I will send him a watch. 因为今天是他的生日，所以我送他一个，我一块儿手表。因为今天是他的生日，所以我送他一块手表。Okay, 因为，所以 ，because, so something. 因为今天下雨，所以我不去跑步。So I'm not going to running because it's raining today. 所以我不去跑步。Or I don't want to. 我不想跑步。Because and so. Sometimes you can just, you know, without saying because. 今天下雨。Which is abbreviated the reason. 今天下雨，所以我不去跑步。Or you can say a lot of multiple things, one and two and three, and give your conclusion and last, 所以 conclusion. Okay? 所以 blah blah blah. The decision. 好了 ,next one, 253. Wait, 254.It's so small. 这么小。254. Ooh, 他 You know we have three different 他, right? So let me just mark the... this. It refers to it. 他 in China, if it's not a man or people, you refer this to an animal, or to something with no life. Okay? 一只狗, you can use. 它一直不吃饭, always not eating.那只狗, let's change to 那, because we're specifically saying 那只狗它一直不吃饭它 okay? And the other 它 is one male 它 another one female 它 and the plural of them which is 它们 and 它们 This is very simple 255踢足球踢足球 so 踢 means to kick. Did you see this radical? 足 means foot. So 踢足球踢足球足球 foot, ball, football, kicking football. when we're talking about football, not talking about American football, like soccer. All right, here it's soccer. Kicking football, you can say it in the more proper English way, which is to play football. Okay, also you can use kick to, why you kick me? 你为什么踢我? Or don't kick the dog. Don't kick the dog, some bad people. 别踢他, don't kick it, don't kick him, don't kick her. We don't say in China, it's animals using this 他. 好了,别踢他, 250. This one, 踢. And this one is question. T. And you can ask, how many questions do you have in your exam? 你有几? Remember the measure word for this is 到. If it's a question on the test, and this is 到. You don't have to remember this, but I hope you know that we mention it here. 你有几道题? 你有几道题? 快点写. After this, I want to go home. 快点写. Okay. 你有几道题? 快点写. 题. And we can expand to 257, which is 问. 问. 问 is to ask. 问. To ask. 好. And then it grows another word. You can say 请问, remember? 请问, where is the forbidden city? 请问, or you can say 我能问你一些事情吗? Can I ask you something? 我能问你一些事情吗? Can I ask you something? 好, and combine 问 and 请. This one literally means question, and also means refers to problems. But 题 itself doesn't have the meaning of life problems. 问题, 问题. I have 几个问题. But then you don't say 我有几道问题. Just say 我有几个问题. And if you say 你是不是, it depends on the context. If you ask sincerely 你是不是 想问我问题? Or do you want to ask me a question? Are you going to ask me questions? 你是不是想问我问题? Alright, this is 问题. And if you try to say, express the meaning of problems, and you can say two levels of meaning. First level, the literal problems, it's just problems. 这个电脑有问题. So there's some problems of this computer. 这个电脑有问题. It doesn't mean the computer itself have some questions to ask you. Okay, it means it has some bad problems. It doesn't work really well. 这个电脑有问题. So my you know, 出 means out, right? So my cell phone have some problems. It started to have some problems, or it burst to some problems. 我的手机出问题了. Second conscious meaning, which is like refers to people, all right? And you can say 你有问题吗? It depends on the tone you say it. 你有问题? 你是不是有问题? And normally they pointed at their head. Do you have problems here? 你脑子有问题吗? 你脑子有问题吗? Very offensive. Okay? Very offensive. So 问题 have so many, you know, different meanings. Make sure you choose the correct one. If you asking a person or refers to any body parts of this person, and it can be a little bit offensive. Okay, so based on what you're trying to express. 259. Which is 跳舞. Do you like 跳舞? 你喜欢跳舞吗? To dance, 跳舞. And you can say, if you ask somebody politely, would you please dance with me? 你想跟我, do you want, 你想跟我, with me, 一起, together, do what, 跳舞. 你想跟我一起跳舞? It's not a question yet, ma. Do you want to dance with me? Do you want to dance with me? 你想跟我一起跳舞吗? 你想跟我一起跳舞吗? Let us dance. 让我们跳舞吧. Let us dance. Let's dance. And also you can say 跳跳舞, like at the beginning I said 跑跑步, 跳跳舞. Or you can put the other stuff in there. For example, a time adverb, a time phrase as adverb. 我爸爸喜欢跳吃完饭后, after eating, finish the dinner, 吃完饭后, 跳一个小时舞, dance for one hour. My daddy likes to dance 1 hour after finish his meal. 我爸爸喜欢吃完饭后跳一个小时舞. Okay, this is dancing, 跳舞. And also you can put the other stuff in there to describe what kind of 舞 it is. You can say 跳 Chinese middle age group, especially 40 to 60 years old females. They like to dance the square dance, and the square dance is 广场舞. Okay, so dance the 广场舞. Where is your mom? 你妈妈去哪儿了? My mom is dancing the square dance. 我妈妈在跳广场舞. My mom is dancing the square dance. 我妈妈在跳广场舞. 广场舞. 好. And then we have 260. Why? This is an easy one. We're just quickly gonna go through this one. Why? And it means outside. You can say 外边 or 外面. And the more you learn, you will say a very oral one, 外头. 外头, it's the same thing. opposite meaning will be 里面、里边、里面、里头、里头。Okay, why 里 ？All right, let's continue. 二百六十 one, which is means finish. One.Finish or end, and it normally use the after verb. Normally, you can say 吃完饭 finish dinner, 跑完步 don't forget to stretch. After running, don't forget to stretch. 跑完步 and then after dance, 跳完舞 跳完舞 Normally, you will put something.After verb. And also you can have this expression, 完了完了 Okay, which means I am done. I am done. 完了 Which basically to express your desperation. Desperately, 完了I'm done. I'm finished. This is the end of me because I didn't finish my homework. 我没写作业 Or you can put whatever situation. 我忘了 I forgot. 上班 I forgot to go to work. 完了完了 You know? And sometimes people just say 完了完了完了完了 So I'm done. You know?I'm desperate. There's no chance for me, no hope for me, because I didn't do something. It's just an extreme expression. 好 and we can have another example. 写完作业 写完作业，写完作业。好，二百六十二。War, you simply the same pronunciation, same pinyin, and you put er after it, which this one is literally means to play. 我喜欢玩电脑游戏 I like to play computer games. 我喜欢玩电脑游戏。你怎么每天都 How come you every day 玩手机 Okay, 玩手机别玩了快回家吃饭别玩了快回家吃饭玩 to play, to have fun 263晚上 means late night or the general name for after the sunset you can all call it 晚上 which means night I forgot 上晚上 night. And if it's morning, we say 早上 This is early morning. If it's late morning, we say 上午 There's no strict timeline, like for example, what time, what clock to what clock.Is the morning, what clock to what clock is in, you know, the late morning. There's no specific answer for that. Normally before 10 o'clock, you can call it 早上. After 10 o'clock to 12, you call it 上午. But it's not strict. And 中午, which is noon, refers to the time maybe from 12 o'clock to 2 o'clock. After 2 o'clock will be 下午. Okay, there means afternoon. 上午、中午、下午. And then it's our favorite word, that's 晚上. 晚上. Okay, I made up all of this. So you can have a quick remember for this. Then we continue. 我们继续264网。网, this is a preposition word, and it means to or towards.Okay, 往, go somewhere, and for example, work forward for a while, and you will say the hospital. 往, forward, 往前, 往前走, 你会看见那个医院. You will see that doctor if you keep walking. Wang Zuo Zhou. Walk to the left. Wang Yu Kai Chu. Wang Yu Kai. Alright. Wang Yu Kai. Wang Yu Kai. Drive to the right. This is the preposition word Wang. Alright. And 265.二百六十五，为什么？为什么 ？Which means why? You can say 你为什么不去上课 ？Why are you not going to the class? Okay.Where you put it in front, 为什么我没有钱? Why I don't have money? 为什么我没有钱? Okay, that's 为什么, that's very simple. And when you answer it, you say 因为 blah 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 blah. Whatever the reason is, then you plus your reason. 好了, then 266. A fruit, a summer fruit, which is...西瓜Or you say 西瓜 Both correct 西瓜 This is a watermelon And 瓜 is literally melon And we have a couple of different 瓜 We say 哈密瓜 Okay?And, 地瓜, it can mean potato or tomato, potato or sweet potato, 地瓜, 甜瓜, sweet, melon. So it means melon or the melon-shaped, fruits or vegetables, it depends. 267.希望 this one can be a noun and also can be a verb. Okay, so you can say 我希望 I hope 我希望明天下雨 I hope tomorrow is raining.I hope tomorrow is raining. And 去中国学习是我的一个希望 This is the usage of noun. So how it depends if you want to use a wish and plus one sentence where you say one sentence and tell that's your one wish. 好吗希望 the negative is 我不希望. 我不希望他送我手机好了，我不希望他送我手机. I don't hope. 好, 268. 洗, to wash. This is a simple verb because it doesn't have so many weird meanings. It just means to wash something. This is obviously a verb. 嗯, and you can say 我洗衣服. Wash dishes, 洗碗, 洗碗, wash dishes. And basically whatever you want to wash, you just plus 洗. Okay, so there's two different kinds, and 水洗 means water clean, and 干洗 means dry clean. If you go to Chinese a laundry store, which is called 洗衣店, wash clothes shop, so 洗衣店, and you got to ask them if you want prefer 水洗 or prefer 干洗. Normally 干洗, dry clean, is for expensive clothes, where the clothing materials need special requirements of, you know, cleaning. 269, 小时. 小时, which means hour. And 你有 几个小时的汉语课? So how many hours do you have for your Chinese class? 你有几个小时的汉语课? 小时. 我等了两个小时. 他还没来. 他还没来. I waited 2 hours, he's still not here. 他还没来. 我等了两个小时. 他还没来. Alright, 小时 is like period of time for hour, 小时. Alright, 270. 笑. A funny thing is when I look at these characters, I feel like smiling. Because the more you look at this character, the top of it is kind of like a smiling eyes. Oh, I put the wrong tone. It's supposed to be falling tone. 笑, 笑. To smile or to laugh. 我笑了笑, 我笑了, I laughed. Okay. 他笑了笑. Very short of period of time. 你笑一下. Please, can you give me a smile? 你笑一下好吗? Okay, and the opposite meaning, which is 哭. 哭. Where's 呜? Oh, here. 哭. Crying. It's kind of like, tears dropping down. Cry. 哭. 好了, very simple verb. 271, 心, 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 adjective, new something, new, okay, 心, 同学, new classmates, 新衣服, new clothes, 新手机, 啊, 这是我的新手机. This is my new cell phone. 这是我的新手机. And the opposite meaning is 旧, 旧. And you can say 我的衣服旧了, 旧了. 这是一件, this is one, 旧衣服. This is old衣服. Or you can say 老, Also, it's the meaning of the opposite meaning of 心, 心. 好, 272. 性, 性, which is can be a verb and also can be a noun. Okay, so 性, verb or noun. So you can ask people, 请问你姓什么? What's your last name? What is your last name? And if you want to be more formal, more polite, you're going to ask, 请问您? 贵, 贵 is the same character with expensive. So we think the opponent, the people you're talking to is more expensive, more important. Okay? So we will say, 您贵姓? 请问您贵姓? And if you can understand it, then, but you want to use it, just remember this, 您贵姓? And then the other people will say, 免贵. 免 means forget about 贵. Okay, I'm not, this is being polite. I'm not that important. 免贵. 姓王, for example. Okay, no 贵, I'm just 姓王. It's not 贵姓. That's the polite way how you answer it. But you cannot ask 您免贵. Alright? And or you can say 李是我的姓. 李是我的姓. Okay, so that's my last name. 李是我的姓. And 海是我的名字. So 名字 normally refer to the given name, but in general it also means refer to the whole name. Okay, it's a little bit confusing, but you will get used to it. That's okay, no problem. 心, 休息. This is one of the students' favorite word, because when they have the need. Xiuxi, to take a break. To take a break. 休息, 休息. So 我们休息休息. Alright, you can ABAB structure to say it. 休息休息 means a short period of time to do this verb. And this can be a verb. Okay, so now it's 休息时间. So resting time. 我们休息一下. So that's 休息. 下一个, next one, 274. 雪. 嗯。No. How can I type you? Oh, there we go. Ooh. Literally means snow. And you can say 雪人, snowman. Do you want to build a snowman? 雪人. Then you can say 雪花, which is snowflake. Okay. So this is, or you can use it as verb. 明天会下雪吗? Is tomorrow gonna snow or not? So this is pretty much 雪, then you can use it. Alright, 275, which is 颜色. This is the general name for colors. So not much to talk about. So you can say 这张 or 这幅画有很多颜色. Alright, so now it's autumn, it's getting to autumn. So you can say 秋天, autumn, 有很多颜色. Okay, there's a lot of color, lot of color. 好了, 276. And this is one of the body parts, 眼睛. Pay attention to the left part of this. Remember the character 看, right? It also have this. This is called 目 radical. 目 radical, which literally means eyes. Okay. So my left eye 我的左眼, my eyes 我的眼睛. Or you can say my glasses, 我的眼镜. So they're different. 镜 means lens, 眼镜. My glasses, 我的眼镜. Okay, 277. 羊肉. I have something to recommend it to you guys. Yang Rou. So this one means mutton, Yang Rou. And if it's beef, will be Niu Rou. And if it's chicken, will be Ji Rou. Oh, not this Ji Rou. Chicken, or you can say pork, 猪肉. So whatever the animal is, then plus meat, that's the different words. And if you go to Beijing, and please try this, 涮, which means to put the something in hot water, and which is called 涮羊肉. Alright, this is for hot pot. Hot pot. 涮羊肉火锅. And you can try to find a hot pot shop to try it. Okay. 278. This 药, which means medicine. Which means medicine or pills. 我生病了，你吃药了吗？ Okay, if they ask you, you say I'm sick, and they will ask you 你吃药了吗？ Alright, and if you want to say I want to buy. 我想买一些, buy some. If you catch a cold, you say 感冒. 我想买一些感冒药. Alright, very simple, not much to talk about it. 279. This 药. Which means to want something, okay? Or would like to do something. For example, let me put ping in here. This is a verb. Okay. 我要吃东西. I want to eat something. 我要去北京. I would like to go to Beijing. Okay, I want to go to Beijing. If you order something,请问我能要一个面包吗？Okay, so 要 something. You want something. 270, 280. We have 20 words to go. Wait, this one. Yeah. Unlike in English, and this yeah means also and too. Okay, and 我也喜欢。For the first person, 我喜欢看电影. The second people say, 我也喜欢看电影. 他是中国人. 我也是中国人. But I have to remind you guys, 也 is never ever used at the end of a sentence. Never ever, it never happened. Okay? 他是中国人, comma, yeah. So this is a wrong sentence. Then you know it. 好, 281, 一下. It changed to rising tone because 下 is falling tone. So 一下. So how do you use this? This one is used after a verb to indicate short action or attempt. Okay? For example, you can say 吃一下, which means give it a try. 休息一下, short period of time. 试一下, this is literally means give it a try. Give it a try. 试 means try. 试一下. 看一下. Alright, so have a look. Have a very quick look. Okay. So maybe normally this time 一下 can be means very short period of time to repeat this verb. Okay, and next one. 已经. Alrighty, this is an adverb. Alrighty, for example, I have already finished my homework. 我已经写完. So if it's an adverb, you put it in, normally you will put it in front of a verb. 我已经写完作业了. 我已经 回家了, 他已经走了, she has gone. Okay, 他已经走了. I don't like Chinese food anymore. So, 我已经不喜欢中国菜了. Before I liked it, but now, no, too much, 太多了. 283, I'm just joking, I love Chinese food. 一起. together, so 我们一起去, sorry, this is an adverb. 我们一起去跳舞, 我们一起跑步, 他们一起吃饭, 他们一起在学校学汉语, okay? Learn Chinese in schools. 284, together. 意思 So is it's a noun which literally means meaning. Okay, so I will ask 这个字什么意思? So this, what's the meaning of this character? Alright, or I can say 你说的话, the words you talked, 是什么意思? Well, people always say, when people say something, the other people don't understand, and you will say 你什么意思? Or simply just 什么意思? I don't get it. 什么意思? 好. Is have more rich meanings here, but in order not to confuse you guys now, and we will learn the more meaning in the future. Okay, it related to Chinese culture, social culture. So we'll skip this one. 285. 因为 So we're not going to expand this one because earlier we already explained this one. So we quickly go through this. If you don't know how to use it, you can go back and see. 因为, normally, if there's a question, ask 为什么, blah, blah, blah. And then you will answer 因为 plus reason. 为什么你送我花? Why you send me flower? 因为我爱你, because I love you. Because I love you. 因为我爱你, 因为我爱你. 好, 286. 因 This is an adjective to describe the weather. It means cloudy. Or you can say 今天是阴天. 今天是阴天. Or 天有点阴. Maybe 可能, maybe 会 下雪, maybe it's gonna snow. 阴, okay? Alright. And 287. A favorite, my favorite activity, one of them. So this one, 游, 泳, 游泳, to swim. A verb. To swim. 游泳. 我喜欢游泳. Where swimming pool will be 游泳池. Swimming pool. Swimming suit will be Yongyi. It doesn't have Yo again because Yo Yongyi sounds like a very twisted town. So this is swimming suit. Yongyi. It's getting small again. Yo Yongyi. Okay. So 288. Yobian. This is a too simple. I think it's already very way too simple for you guys. Because we practiced them multiple times. Yobian, right. GHGHT, right side. Yobian. Where for the left it will be 左边, for the top 上边, for the down 下边. Okay, and also 里边, 外边, 前边, and 后边. Okay, so left, up, down, inside, outside, in front, back, in the back, behind. 好, 289. 鱼, 鱼. It's the general name for all kinds of fish. 鱼. Not much to talk about it. 猫, 喜欢吃鱼. Okay. 大鱼, 小鱼. Also, they will have, even though it's not a fish, but it looks like a fish. For example, 鲨鱼, guess what it is? It's a shark. 鲨鱼. Okay. Or if it's a fish market, and we'll call it 鱼市. Fish market. So if you like it, okay. 290. 远. Ooh, what is that? 远. Which this one means literally means far, okay, far. So that is too far. The opposite meaning, which is 近, 近, which means near. 他家离 away from 我家, 他家离我家很近. His house is near to my house. The distance between our house is very close. 他家离我家很近, 很近. Alright, 下一个, which is 291, means 运动, which is sport. 我喜欢运动. I like sports. Okay. 你做什么运动? What kind of sports do you do? What kind of sports do you do? You know, judo, maybe other things. 踢足球, maybe 打篮球. It depends. 在. So which means again, or once more, okay? 明天我再去一次学校。Tomorrow I'll go to school again. 你什么时候再来？ When you will come. When you will come. 你什么时候再来？ Come again. Sorry. 你什么时候再来？ When will you come again? 293going to, you know, discuss more about this, and we already tried this one before. 早上, so which means early morning. 早上, 早上, so you can say, you can say 早上好. That's most of the teacher will say, or simply 早 means good morning. 好. And the next one, same, we're not going to expand it. So this one, 丈夫. Falling tone on A means husband. 我丈夫明天再来. Tomorrow he will come again, my husband. 好。295. We're almost down. 5 to go. Well, actually more than 5. 找. Which is a verb. Means to look for. 请问你找谁？请问你找谁 ？Please, excuse me. Who you're looking for? 你找谁？我找张老师。I'm looking for Miss Zhang. Okay. 好，296。这，you know, because we don't have tens in Chinese.So 这。It's neutral. So 这 is to show you that to indicate the verb is going on. For example, 跑着, 跑着 is running, which means just doing this and that. 吃着, okay, eating. 好吗？Alright, 297. 正在，正在, which is in the process of doing something. 。For example, you can say, because 这 is always also used to indicate a verb, it's going on. Okay? Let's just call it ing form. 正在我他丈夫, for example, 丈夫回来的时候, when he's coming back, 我正在, I am in the middle of, 我正在吃饭, I am eating food, I'm eating food. 他正在打电话, 请你等一下。请你等一下，他正在打电话，请你等一下。好 ，and 298. This is 正在。知道。To know something. 我知道这个汉字怎么写。我不知道他几点回家。299。准备。准备。To prepare, to plan.It's the same with, kind of like the same with 打算, but this one only have the meaning of verb, function of verb, it cannot be a noun, okay? To prepare. 明天去上海,我准备一下。Let me prepare a little bit. 你准备好了吗? Are you ready? Are you prepared well? 你准备好了吗?Alright, 300. 最。最。This one means the most. 最。This is an adverb. Means most. Okay, 我最喜欢吃。水果 I like eat fruit the most 最他最好的他是最好的足球运动员 He's the best soccer player 你是最漂亮的 You're the most beautifulperson, okay? 你是最漂亮的 or 我的妈妈最好 My mom is the best 我的妈妈最好 Okay, so this is pretty much all of the 300 HSK2 vocabulary and the homework will be uploaded on Moodle as well and I hope you guys enjoyed this video and I'll see you guys next week. Bye bye!